We've heard a lot about voter suppression as we approach Election Day. So what is it, and how does it manifest itself? First, a little history. At the height of the Civil Rights Movement, when leaders such as the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. and John Lewis marched against legalized black voter disenfranchisement, President Lyndon B. Johnson signed into law a landmark piece of legislation that prohibited racial discrimination in voting. This was called the Voting Rights Act of 1965. Despite the law, efforts to thwart voting for minorities has persisted ever since, and in some states, it has worsened because of a 2013 Supreme Court ruling that gutted a section of the law requiring states with a history of racially discriminatory voting rules to get federal approval before changing voter regulations. Today, this is called voter suppression. Voter suppression takes on many forms, from purging voter rolls and limits on early voting to intimidation at the polls and denying convicted felons the right to vote. Courts have struck down some of these rules when it was clear they were designed to disproportionately disenfranchise black and Hispanic voters. The Republican National Committee plans to recruit thousands of poll watchers for the upcoming election now that the GOP is no longer under a court order banning the practice. Democrats argue this is essentially voter intimidation. Another example is strict voter ID laws, such as in Texas. Minorities are much more likely than whites to lack accepted voter ID. Voting rights advocates also argue that President Donald Trump's efforts to scare voters from casting their ballots by mail is another form of voter suppression. The president denies the claim.